Imagine a skyscraper so massive it was meant to rival the world's tallest buildings, but it's been abandoned for years, frozen in time. This is Goldin Finance 117, a 600-meter giant in Tianjin, China, that's become a symbol of ambition and failure. Why did this $8 billion dream stall? Stick around to uncover the shocking truth behind one of the world's most mysterious megastructures. Welcome back to Blueprint Boss, where we dive into the world's most incredible architectural marvels and the stories behind them. Today, we're exploring Goldin Finance 117, a skyscraper that was supposed to redefine China's skyline. At 117 floors and nearly 600 meters tall, it was designed to be one of the tallest buildings on Earth. But here's the kicker. Construction started in 2008, and over a decade later, it's still unfinished. What went wrong? Was it a design flaw, financial ruin, or something else entirely? In this video, we'll break down the building's bold vision, its jaw-dropping engineering, the challenges that derailed it, and what the future holds for this ghostly titan. If you love stories of ambition, innovation, and epic setbacks, hit that subscribe button and let's get started. Let's set the stage. It's the early 2000s, and China is in the middle of a skyscraper boom. Cities like Shanghai and Beijing are racing to build taller, flashier buildings to showcase their economic power. Tianjin, a port city just 120 kilometers from Beijing, wants in on the action. Enter Goldin Properties, a Hong Kong-based developer with big dreams. Their plan? Build Goldin Finance 117, a skyscraper that would not only dominate Tianjin's skyline, but also compete with global icons like Dubai's Burj Khalifa or New York's One World Trade Center. At 597 meters, about 1,959 feet, Goldin Finance 117 was designed to be China's third tallest building and one of the top five globally. With 117 floors, it would house a mix of ultra-luxury offices, a five-star hotel, high-end apartments, and a public observation deck with panoramic views of Tianjin. The name 117 wasn't random. It symbolized prosperity in Chinese culture and nodded to the building's floor count. The mastermind behind the project was Pan Sutong, Goldin's billionaire chairman. Known for his bold investments in real estate and even racehorses, Pan saw Goldin Finance 117 as his legacy. The building was part of a larger development called Goldin Metropolitan, a sprawling complex meant to transform Tianjin into a financial hub rivaling Hong Kong. The estimated cost? A staggering $8.2 billion. But what made this skyscraper stand out wasn't just its height. The design, crafted by global architecture firm P&T Group, was a blend of futuristic aesthetics and cutting-edge engineering. The tower shape, a sleek, tapering quadrilateral with a diamond-like crown, was inspired by traditional Chinese pagodas but modernized with a glass and steel facade. This wasn't just a building, it was a statement. To pull this off, Goldin Properties assembled a dream team of engineers and contractors. The goal was to create a structure that could withstand earthquakes, typhoons, and the test of time. But, as we'll see, even the best laid plans can unravel. Before we dive into the challenges, let's talk about the engineering feats that made Goldin Finance 117 possible, because this building pushed the limits of what was thought achievable. Building a skyscraper like Goldin Finance 117 isn't just about stacking floors. It's about defying gravity, weather, and physics itself. At nearly 600 meters, this tower had to be a fortress disguised as a work of art. Let's break down the engineering that went into making this dream a reality. First, the foundation. Tianjin's soil is notoriously soft, a mix of clay and silt that's prone to settling. To anchor a 117-story tower, engineers drove hundreds of steel piles deep into the ground, some reaching over 100 meters. These piles support a massive concrete raft foundation, distributing the building's 1.2 million metric tons of weight evenly. For context, that's heavier than 10 Eiffel Towers. Next, the core. Goldin Finance 117 uses a dual-core system, a concrete core surrounded by a steel frame. The concrete core, packed with high-strength rebar, acts like the building's spine, handling vertical loads and resisting earthquakes. The steel frame, meanwhile, provides flexibility, allowing the tower to sway slightly during high winds, a critical feature for a building this tall. Speaking of wind, Tianjin's coastal location means typhoons are a real threat. To combat this, engineers designed the tower's unique shape to reduce wind resistance. The tapering, quadrilateral form minimizes vortex shedding, those swirling wind patterns that can shake a building. The diamond-shaped crown at the top isn't just for show. It's aerodynamically optimized to deflect wind, reducing sway by up to 40%. The facade is another masterpiece. The glass curtain wall system, made of double-glazed panels, is both energy efficient and visually stunning. It's designed to reflect Tianjin's skyline during the day and glow with LED lights at night. Each panel was precision engineered to fit the tower's complex geometry, requiring months of planning and testing. But the real showstopper? The building's damping system. At the top of Goldin Finance 117 sits a tuned mass damper, a giant 1,000-ton steel pendulum that counteracts swaying. If a typhoon hits, the damper swings in the opposite direction of the building's movement, stabilizing it. This tech is so advanced, it's only used in a handful of skyscrapers worldwide, like Taipei 101. By 2015, construction had reached the 97th floor, and the tower was starting to look like the icon it was meant to be. But just when it seemed like Goldin Finance 117 was unstoppable, cracks began to appear. Not in the structure, but in the project itself. Let's dive into the challenges that brought this giant to its knees. By 2015, Goldin Finance 117 was soaring, literally and figuratively. The tower was nearly complete, with its glass facade gleaming and its crown taking shape. But behind the scenes, trouble was brewing. What started as a symbol of China's unstoppable growth became a cautionary tale of overambition. Let's unpack the three biggest challenges that derailed this megaproject. Challenge 1. Financial woes. Goldin Properties bet big on Goldin Finance 117, but their timing couldn't have been worse. In 2015, China's economy hit a rough patch. The country's real estate market, which had been booming for decades, started to cool. Property developers like Goldin relied heavily on debt to fund massive projects, and Goldin Finance 117 was no exception. The project's $8.2 billion price tag was financed through loans, bonds, and investor funds. But as China tightened its financial regulations to curb risky lending, Goldin struggled to secure new funding. Then came a devastating blow. Pan Sutong, Goldin's chairman, made a series of ill-fated investments outside real estate, including a failed bet on Hong Kong's stock market. Goldin's stock price plummeted, and by 2017, the company was hemorrhaging cash. With no money to pay contractors, construction ground to a halt. The tower, stuck at 97 floors, became a ghost of its former promise. Challenge 2. Market oversupply. Even if Goldin had the cash, Tianjin's real estate market was another problem. By the mid-2010s, China was building skyscrapers faster than it could fill them. Tianjin alone had dozens of new office towers, many sitting empty. Goldin Finance 117's plan for luxury offices and apartments relied on a steady stream of high-end tenants, but demand was drying up. Analysts estimated that Tianjin's office vacancy rates were as high as 30% by 2018. Who would lease space in a half-finished skyscraper when cheaper alternatives were everywhere? Challenge 3. Political and regulatory hurdles. China's government also played a role. In the late 2010s, Beijing cracked down on speculative real estate projects, prioritizing affordable housing over vanity projects like Goldin Finance 117. New regulations made it harder for developers to get permits or financing for super tall buildings. Rumors swirled that the government viewed Goldin's tower as a symbol of excess, putting pressure on the project to stall. Whether true or not, the political climate wasn't in Goldin's favor. By 2018, the tower was a skeleton, its upper floors exposed to the elements, its construction cranes frozen. Social media dubbed it China's tallest ghost tower, and it became a magnet for urban explorers and photographers. For Pan Sutong and Goldin Properties, the dream was crumbling. But was this the end? Let's look at what happened next and whether there's hope for this unfinished giant. So, where does Goldin Finance 117 stand today? As of 2025, the tower remains unfinished, a haunting silhouette on Tianjin skyline. But the story isn't over. Let's explore the legacy of this project and what the future might hold. The legacy. Goldin Finance 117 is more than just a stalled skyscraper. It's a symbol of China's real estate boom and bust. During the 2000s and early 2010s, China built thousands of high-rises, transforming cities like Tianjin into modern metropolises. But projects like Goldin's Tower exposed the risks of unchecked ambition. Developers took on massive debt, assuming the economy would keep growing forever. When it didn't, towers like Goldin Finance 117 became monuments to hubris. The tower also sparked debates about urban planning. Should cities prioritize super tall buildings or focus on sustainable, human-scale development? Critics argue that Goldin's tower was more about ego than practicality, a vanity project that ignored Tianjin's actual needs. Yet, supporters say it could still inspire growth, attracting businesses and tourists if completed. The future. As for what's next, there are glimmers of hope. In 2023, reports surfaced that Goldin Properties was seeking new investors to restart construction. The company has floated plans to scale back the project's scope, focusing on completing the lower floors for commercial use rather than luxury apartments. Some experts believe the tower could be repurposed as a mixed-use hub, with retail, co-working spaces, and cultural venues. But challenges remain. Finishing the tower would cost billions, and Tianjin's oversupplied real estate market hasn't fully recovered. There's also the question of structural integrity. After years of exposure, the tower's steel and concrete may need extensive repairs. If Goldin can't secure funding, the tower could face demolition, though that's unlikely given its symbolic value. For now, Goldin Finance 117 stands as a paradox, a testament to human ingenuity and a warning about overreaching. It's a reminder that even the grandest blueprints can falter without the right foundation, financially, politically, and socially. Whether it rises to glory or remains a ghost tower, its story captivates us because it's not just about a building. It's about the dreams and risks that shape our world. That's the story of Goldin Finance 117, a skyscraper that reached for the stars but got stuck in the clouds. From its bold vision to its groundbreaking engineering and heartbreaking setbacks, this tower teaches us that ambition alone isn't enough. It takes resilience, strategy, and a bit of luck to turn a blueprint into reality. What do you think? Can Goldin Finance 117 make a comeback, or is it destined to remain a ghost tower? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. We read every single one. If you enjoyed this deep dive, give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more stories about the world's most incredible builds. Want to see us cover another mega project? Let us know in the comments or check out our playlist on super tall skyscrapers, linked on screen now. Thanks for watching, Blueprint Bosses. Keep dreaming big, and we'll see you in the next one.